Here's a new eGPU from the company, known for creating one of the best Thunderbolt eGPUs on the market. It's much smaller and doesn't use a power supply from the desktop PC. Surprisingly, I couldn't find any reviews for it on YouTube, so I ordered an option with a case from AliExpress to check it out myself. The package came in this box. Inside you can find general information about this eGPU and the case itself with a small package inside. It's nice to see that the case is already assembled and the eGPU dock is connected to it. There is a power button on the front for the Oculink version, but for the Thunderbolt version it will work just as an indicator. Also, in the box was a 1/2 meter Thunderbolt 4 cable and the power cables in the white package. The case looks much smaller than the previous version, and in general, I like it more. But I want to warn you right away that you can fit a 2-slot GPU here at most, and not every 2-slot GPU. For example, my RTX 2060 has a power port connector on the top, and as soon as I plug in an 8-pin connector, the case cover can be closed. I mean, you can screw one bolt on the left side, but I'm disappointed. Luckily, I have another GPU that has power port located slightly deeper. It's RTX 4060 from GaN V2. The case closes completely, and now I like how it looks. If you disassemble the case, you'll see the tiny dock itself. On the back side, there are two Thunderbolt 4 ports, one of them with power delivery up to 85 watts. And the second can be used for connecting peripherals or external SSD with games, as I did before. There is a small fan on the back, and that's not a good sign, as they are often noisy. Anyway, we put everything back together, plug in the RTX 4060, power cable, and now we need a power supply. On the back of the eGPU dock, there is a connector like this. It may vary depending on the model you choose when ordering. One of them is for power supplies from Lenovo laptops, and the other for Dell. Perhaps someone has one of these and will be able to save some money. Someone will find a fairly cheap version or used at the local market. But be aware that the maximum power supply can be up to 330 watts, which additionally creates limits when choosing a GPU. So if you plan to use a large graphics card like RTX 4090 for AI or something, it's better to choose another eGPU dock. If you can't find the right power supply or you just don't want to waste your time, I bought this one for 330 watts also on AliExpress. It's made for Dell laptops, which is perfect for me. I will share the links to this power supply and eGPU dock in the description. In my case, RTX 4060 consumes around 110 watts, so I can use it with the power delivery. Just like in the old eGPU dock, when we plug in the power supply, we have an indicator with the blue light on. And when it's connected to our device, in my case it's the One Explorer X1 handheld. The light turns green, as does the power button on the front. And after a few seconds, our GPU is detected. And the list of games that can be comfortably played on this handheld increases dramatically. Remember, I mentioned the small fan. Yeah, it's noticeable. Although it's not very loud, but it creates background noise even when the GPU is idle. And under the load, this case slowly turns into a hot oven because it's made of metal. There is no exhaust, all this heats up, and the coolers only start working louder. On the open bench, my GPU heats up to 68 degrees. In this case, after 15 minutes, 75 degrees. The exhaust fan is sorely lacking here, because when I add it, the temperature quickly drops to 69 degrees. But actually, my GPU can be a problem here, because the airflow does not go through thanks to the strange design of the radiator. There's even a cutout on the backside for that, so... But no worries, I know how to fix that. Just open the case, and the temperature of the GPU drops to 70 degrees. Or for the very desperate, you can screw a 120mm fan here. You just need to find a way to power it up. But that doesn't sound right. Compared to the old model, which I've had for about 2 years now, there were no such limitations. Without a case, you can connect any GPU, even 4090 as I did in my videos, or even future RTX 5090, because you can connect any power supply there. Well, it doesn't look as cool as this new eGPU, you can add a case there too, but with that case, there will be a limitation for a 2-slot GPU at most. What about the performance? The bandwidth speed is actually what you should expect from a Thunderbolt connection. It has its pros and cons compared to other eGPU connection methods, but I won't touch on this topic here, as I already have quite a few videos about it. If you're interested, then check out my eGPU playlist. The new eGPU has many requirements. You need to find a suitable power supply up to 330 watts. The GPU must be a 2-slot and not long. And if you want to use power delivery, do not forget about this table. The power connector should be located deep in the GPU, or you can find an angled 8-pin adapter, which I didn't initially think of. And preferably a pass-through radiator. For example, this RTX 4070 from Palit looks like a matching variant. That being said, this eGPU might be a good variant for many. Not everyone needs to plug in a top-of-the-line GPU for AI tasks, and considering the loss of performance in games, not everyone will want to plug in an expensive GPU. Something like RTX 4060 is enough to play most games comfortably. But that's just my opinion. Let me know if you think I'm wrong. And if this video was useful for you, give it a like. Bye!